Hey guys, welcome back to Final Fantasy XIV, Heaven's Ward. We've done a lot of things. We've met Bismarck, and we also saved the elf and the Lanafell. So, not done quite a few bad things. We need to go talk to this guy beforehand. I can't remember why. Soak about Tattoo or something. They don't have to be released yet or something. I don't know. Let's find out. Oh, there was me thinking I was hoping he would fucking speak. Just ran up the stairs, sat down, pressed the record button, and I'm like, damn, I am fucking just unhealthy. Whew! Okay, anyway. Those miles on you, yes, Master Tribal, guarding the unit of victory and setting your comrades free. I confess I did fear for your safety, but you are very good. Besting the two Heaven's Ward whilst the city elite looked on. Simply amazing, Master Tribal. There we go. Like I said, we're doing the cliff notes. But, my lord. Or? I received a message from the vault. Oh, the Archbishop requests the presence of Master Tribal. An invitation from the Archbishop? What an honor! A personal summons is indeed a great honor. And given recent events, you would be wise not to delay. Go, Master Tribal. We shall speak anon. I assume that means he gets back. Identify yourself to him and he will escort you inside. Okay! Wow, the Archbishop wants to see us. That's pretty impressive. I mean, we must have made a good impression saving the elf and the Lanafell. Or we must have made a bad impression by embarrassing two of his elite guards. Either way, I guess we'll find out if he's pissed or happy with it. Oh, that was Ashlogian. 32. I do love their animations. It's very elegant. Right, so we're heading up here. Wow, Ishkan is beautiful in the daytime. I feel like whenever we're here, it's just fucking snowing and dark. Okay, oh, but so yeah, actually, before we go in there, let me just show you guys something. So I locked the air currents, and I found all 10 air currents, but you have 5 air currents which are due to quests, and I've asked around and this is for every single thing. You have 10 air currents that you have to find using the compass, and then 5 that you have to do during quests. I have not got those quests, that's why I didn't start the episode flying. Hello, Ishkanian priest. We're honored to receive you, Master Tribal. This way, please. Okey-doke. Lead the way, priesty. Very official. Oh my god, look at this. Look at this. Look at that guy. He's a dark knight and a half, isn't he?
Your Eminence, it is my honor to present to you the Warrior of Light.
What's up?
I have heard the tales of your many grand endeavors. The Lord Commander has also been most effusive in his praise. I am Thordon the Seventh, Archbishop of the Ishkadian Orthodox Church, and I bade you come here that I might offer my personal apologies. You will forgive me for not calling upon you as courtesy would dictate, but as you can see, my more sprightly days are long behind me. But I digress. Your companions were wrongly accused of heresy and subjected to gross indignities. This, I am sorry to say, was the result of negligence on the part of our nation's protectors. Negligence born of an excess of zeal. Is that not so, Sir Zephyrin?
Yes, Your Eminence. Regrettably, it would appear.
Oh, damn, that guy is fucking badass.
In receipt of erroneous information. Sir Grinno has ever been headstrong. He pressed charges before the truth had been ascertained, for which I most sincerely apologize.
An unfortunate misunderstanding born of an earnest desire to serve Ishgard, but one which should never have occurred. For who could doubt the character of those who bested Shiva and drove the Horde from the steps of faith? Not I. That much is certain. That will be all, Sir Zephyrin. I would speak with our guest in private.
Your Eminence? As you wish, Your Eminence. That will be all for today.
He like jumps out of his chair and goes a fucking like Yoda on her ass, bouncing off the walls and shit.
Privacy is a luxury rarely afforded one in my position. Now, tell me, young man, what do you know of the Asians?
I know that they're pricks. I know that they're fucking assholes. I know they kidnapped my friend. I know they killed another one of my friends. I know I don't like them very much. They're not very nice.
More, I shouldn't wonder, being the bringer of light. You should know that I myself have met with them, have entertained them as guests, even.
Oh, really?
Those harbingers of chaos and strife offered us power that we might continue our war against the dragons. I have no intention of aiding their cause, of course. Not yet, were I to refuse them outright, I should learn naught of their true objectives and remain powerless to stop them. Thus have I hearkened to their words with interest and paid lip service to their beliefs.
But we know that they can, like, possess
and
people.
Why do I tell you this? Because there is naught in this world they fear more than the power of the Warrior of Light.
I don't have the power of the Warrior of Light anymore.
If we are to rid ourselves of these vile interlopers, we must need work together. With our combined strength, I have faith that we can wrest Eorzea from their grasp and pave the way for a lasting peace. Think on it.
Okay. I mean, I still don't have the power of the light, but... yeah. I got a dragon with me, though. I mean, there's that. I traded it for this little cute baby dragon thing that, like, follows me around. It's not like the Yu-Gi-Oh card, like an actual proper baby dragon. It's like a little flying little baby dragon. Oh, it's got... Okay, but don't you worry, we'll have tea later, I guess. Jesus. How about fucking kicking me out? Yeah, I'm actually like thinking that, oh god, I wish Ishgard wasn't so big, I wish it was more compact. But it's actually no bigger than what like Uldar is, by the looks of it on the map. Hello, can I please go inside? Thank you. Let's return to House Tutti Frutti and explain what's happened. Oh, Lala, my elf, how are you doing?
There you are. I confess, I was more than a little concerned when I learned that you had been summoned to the vault. What?
Yeah, I went to see the Archbishop.
Well, well. A formal apology and an admonishment of those responsible. I see my fears were wholly misplaced. By the gods, the Archbishop freely admits to consorting with Ascians. So, their ambitions extend to Ishgard as well.
I guess.
We will have new primals to contend with erelong, of that you may be certain. Tis but a matter of time. Yet shorn of the support of our missing allies, what can we realistically hope to achieve?
In the midst of all the excitement, I completely forgot to tell you.
Tell me what?
When I was asking around about the Scions, I heard the most awful rumor.
Oh?
General Rauban is to be executed for crimes against the Sultanate!
What the fuck? That's something that you should probably tell me.
If the Flame General dies,
that sounds important.
He's a staunch ally, and the one man capable of holding the Sultana's assassins to account. Lord Orshifon was wise to counsel restraint, but this business will brook no delay. We cannot permit this execution to take place. We must save Rauban.
I agree with you. I like him. I mean, he's... The traveling to Uldar might cost us an arm and a leg, but it's fine. Those who don't know, in the last cutscene, he lost an arm. The situation calls for urgency. It is as we arrive. It's a little change. I'm holding to Uldar without a plan. Okay. Right. So does blah 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 blah. Admiral, please, itself. The duty sees it. I'm happy to report that we yet scout an ally in Limsa. The Admiral has pledged her full cooperation in any effort to rescue Rimbaran. Fantastic! Sorry, I feel a bit... My throat feels a little bit closed. Lucky number 7. I don't know what that achievement was for, but I'm sure it's fine. Right, so you want me to go and arrive in Limsa and talk with a guy? Okie doke. Oh, it's actually a woman, isn't it? Sorry, my bad. Okay, let's go to the lower docks then. First I want to see what the fuck is that doing there? Oh my god, has that been there the entire time? I am so sorry. I'm so sorry. Okay, so let's... achievements, yes. That's 5. Okay, just quick complete the quest. Okay, that's fine. Let us teleport to Limsa. Seriously, I feel like I can't do stuff. My throat is like horrible. A little drink. I shouldn't really tower them. That's probably bad news. Especially if they all fall over. I never drink the last little bit. So there'll just be like specks of Coca-Cola and Tango and Fanta and all over my floor if I knock that tower over. Okay, wow, Limbs is back in business. Seriously, I can't get rid of that. What the fuck is wrong with me? We're going the right way. Here we go. Little Limbs. Oh, look, there's a triple triad match over there. That's nice. Zabu? What's up, Zabu? Greenleaf? Hey! I'll tell you, they're fucking everywhere. Proceed to the bridge. Hello, me and my elf have come to talk to you about rescuing our armless friend.
Friends, 'tis good to see you safe and well. I will admit I had not counted on you seeking, let alone finding, refuge within the Holy See, but full glad was I to learn that you had.
Thankfully, we had allies there who took us under their wing, and theirs was not the only aid we receive, I suspect. When we fled Uldar, we fully expected to become wanted men, known to all and hounded at every turn. Yet that did not come to pass. On the contrary, 'twould seem the charges against us have not been made public. Might we have you to thank for that, Admiral?
Sharp as ever, Master Elfino. On Marshal Tarrapin's urging, the Elder Seedseer and I demanded that the Syndicate suppress news of the Scion's alleged crimes until such time as irrefutable evidence could be found. Our argument was simple. Lacking proof to accuse the saviors of the realm of so unlikely a crime would have the people up in arms. In their wisdom, the Syndicate agreed, as you yourself have seen.
Oh, I see. So that's why you could go to Uldar and no one will raise an eyebrow.
There is something you should know. Some few days prior to the banquet, the Elder Seedseer and I were summoned for a private audience with the Sultana. There, she revealed her intent to announce her abdication, that she might pave the way for the establishment of an Uldar Republic.
What? But such an announcement would have plunged the entire nation into chaos.
She was well aware of that. 'Twas for fear of what might ensue that she summoned us. Her Grace wanted the Elder Seedseer and I to lend Rauban a helping hand, you see? To aid him in preserving the peace during the transition.
So, having somehow caught wind of her plan, Lolorito and Taleji plotted the Sultana's assassination in the hope of maintaining the constitutional status quo. But they must have known that her death would sow as much chaos as her abdication. Chaos from which Taleji alone might feasibly stand to profit. Surely Lolorito would never knowingly... Ah! Could it be? I dare not hope.
The Uldan authorities have yet to announce the Sultana's passing. To allay any suspicion that may arise from Her Grace's absence, they have issued a statement to the effect that she is presently convalescing from illness.
Mayhap they're waiting for a fitting moment to break the news. Or mayhap they know of some other reason to delay.
Yeah, because they don't fucking want to tell anybody. So, oh, by the way, the savior of the realm murdered your person. Murdered your beloved Sultana.
I was dismayed to learn that General Rauban is to be executed.
Don't do that.
But upon hearing the news, I could not help but wonder why he had been kept alive for so long. Pray mistake not my meaning.
Yui got back from the adventure.
I am, of course, overjoyed that our friend still draws breath, and that he might yet be saved. But if his enemies truly wished to eliminate him, they could have done so immediately. I see no reason for this delay.
Aye, you've struck upon an important point, Master Alfano. Following his capture, Rauban had been held in the Marasarja pit within Uldar. In recent days, however, he has reportedly been moved to an unknown location. Queerly, 'twas not the brass blades who spirited him away either, but a band of soldiers decked in blue.
The Crystal Braves.
Aye. If I read the winds aright, the arrangement between Lord Lolorito and the Braves has come under strain. At any rate, if we're to rescue Rauban, we'll have to find him first. And you'll be glad to hear that I have already entrusted the task to those best able to see it done. Our friends of Doma.
Who? I don't know who that is. I don't remember who that is. The survivor is vital to the Eurasian Alliance. I cannot afford to lose him. But I cannot send troops into Uldar, which would spell the end of the Alliance. I would have no other way, Admiral. It was I who founded the Crystal Braves. I'm responsible for their actions. Yes, you are. Spoken like a true leader, Elf. By the way, make contact, and I will be able to find her among the frontier hands of the Reverend Toll, working in the kitchen. Okay, so we go to Reverend Toll, which is interesting, if I'm honest with you. I didn't think I'd be back here for a while. Turns out we're back back in the Orzio already. I mean, that's good, because... Do I say back in the Orzio? The whole planet... I think the whole planet is called the Orzio, or the continent is called the Orzio. The Ishgard is also part of the Orzio, but what I mean is, we're already back in, like, the old world, which is good, because that means that this area doesn't get, you know, completely wasted now that the expansion's come out and stuff like that. Okay, so where are we going? We need to go up there. It's all fine. Wow, I have never actually seen this place so empty. That's hard to believe, but I've never seen this place so empty. But let's do this real quick. Whilst we're here. Venger, what the fuck did you bring me? Okay. Thanks, I guess. Off you go. Bring me back something cool. Bye. Okay, so we've been getting a lot of fucking cutscenes lately, which is okay. At least they're voiced, right? So we don't need to hear my bad reading. Hello? Is there not? Is she upstairs, maybe? Let's check upstairs. Hello? Looking for... Doorman. That's not Doorman. That's a high girl. That's a strife. I knew in my heart that you were safe. You weren't even, who the fuck even are you? Even as the victory has first taken place, the Crystal Braves turned upon us and took the Rising Stones by force. Amid the chaos, a few of my compatriots and I were able to slip away unnoticed. Well, you're not very far away. You have done well by us. This Dominion demands do not soon forget our debts. Who the fuck are you? And being honest, I don't remember who you are. Shortly before you arrived, I received word from Limsa that you were searching for Ruban. As the Admiral will inform you, recently has moved to a cell in Masara Pit. The same junction. Sorry, the third unit. We're obliged to leave the Rising Stones. Okay. Escort the Flame General to his execution. Suffices to say that the people's shadowing the third. If you would join the hunt. Yeah, sure. Where are we heading? At the High Bridge. In Fanland, huh? Oh, fuck. What have I done? Fanland, so it's in Eastern Fanland. Oh, over there. Right, okay. That's fine. I guess we'll go Kept Drybone. And we'll run over there. Righty then, so, man, I'm glad that we're using these things. Let's use our black chocobo to show off to everybody. Like, oh la la la, I have a black chocobo. Oh look, a Dark Knight. What level are you? 40? Holy crap, Spectre Wolf Dark Knight. Apparently Odin in our free company saw a level 52 Dark Knight. Like, whoa. A level 52 Dark Knight already. Like, I'm level 52 Bard. You know what I mean? It's like I'm fucking... This is my main and I'm only two levels. He went on a Dark Knight. And within one day, he's at level 52. He was clearly playing, like, all night. There's just no way around that. You just, like, forget that you have a Chocobo? Maybe he doesn't have one. Where are we going? Aha! Around here. Hello. I've been expecting you. I didn't read it. This is the men are bound for Halatili. as we believed that we were going to carry out an execution. The entrance let us make haste to join him. Are we running to Halatili now? Ugh, you could have just asked me to meet you at fucking Halatili. Why did I have to come to the bridge? Fucking, why go? Let's meet at the bridge. And then we'll go to Halatili. Why not just meet at fucking Halatili? Jesus. Look, just nobody's doing this fate. This is the worst fucking fate. Because these guys are just built like a fucking brick shithouse. They just don't die. So it's like you need like four people on one of them. It's crazy. Okay, so we've done this mission as well, so to search for Ruban, so I guess the next mission is going to be to rescue him. Which is good. I'm glad that the quest system is a bit more fleshed out, rather than doing a bunch of go here, slay three of those, blah blah blah. I'm glad that they're all like, they're all set off for things. I don't know who that guy is. They're all set for like side quests and shit. So I don't mind doing those quests, I just prefer them to be side quests. Good time, my friends, but moments ago the traitor Imlad arrived and ended Halatili. From this, it is certain that Ruban is being held within. Alright. Let's fucking go in then. What is this? Oh, rings. Not bad. If you haven't got gear, this is quite fucking good, to be honest with you. There's no time to lose. Okay, let's go. Oh. We're not gonna... Okay. It's a level 51 quest, so level 52, we should be okay. Although these are our own men. For those who don't know, the Crystal Braves was a faction, much like the Aldarian free companies and all that, but... Hey! It's the Dragon Lady Ninja Pray, person.
Forgive me my lateness.
Oh, sorry, you could talk.
Lady Yugiri!
Master Alphenor, I am pleased to see that the light of resolve shines in your eyes once more.
Ah, yes. How pathetic I must have seemed to you when we last met. I am ashamed to record it. For a time, I was well and truly lost. But with the aid of my comrades, I have since refound my purpose, and I shall take care not to misplace it again.
Since your escape from Ulda, my fellow shinobi and I have shadowed the Crystal Braves every step, in hopes of learning the Scion's whereabouts. Regrettably, our investigation has yet to yield any useful information. Pray, forgive us.
You need not apologize, my lady. We are grateful for all that you have done on our behalf. Besides, Ralban is no less a friend, and we cannot well abandon him to his fate.
Hozan! The three of us shall attend to the Flame General's rescue. Pray, draw away the guards by the entrance. Take Doware and Higiri with you.
Whoa, okay. My guy just looks away. Like, oh, fuck me, take that.
With me!
Okay, Dragon Lady. Oh, this is cool. It's like a fucking... We're actually like assaulting them and shit, and I've got some actual people. See, now what would make this better is if they were actually in my party list. You know? That would be cooler. So that my skills actually have an effect on them. Oh, that we're in Halatili. Very cool. Okay. I'm ready. Let's go. Take the lead, Master Strife. I shall follow you upon. Okay. I believe it is I will follow upon you, but... answer for sure. So yes, the Crystal Braves, they were like originally a group set up by the Elf, and like the Aldarian military, you know, like their Flames or the Maelstrom, they were meant to be a third faction. But a lot of them were traitors, and they pretty much did a coup d'etat right at the end, and fucked the Elf and all the Seven Scions over. And then they captured Robin, so we've got to go save him. Which is good, because I really like that guy. He's really cool. That's why he's like the reason I joined the Immortal Flame originally. I was like, that guy's fucking badass. I love the Sultana. It's a shame she died, really, because I really liked her as a character. She's cool eyes. Terrible voice actor. Like, for that role. I think that there's probably better ones there, but... I don't know. I feel like we could have got a better voice actor for the Sultana, but, you know, it's fine. It's not that she did a bad job delivering her lines, it's more the fact that I just didn't think that that voice suited that character. But she died, and I quite liked that character. Her lines were interesting and stuff. Like, she wanted to dissolve the monarchy, which is interesting. It's very interesting. But that all fucked up when they're poisoned. She died quite graphically, actually. I think we can cheat. Come on, guys, down here. Yeah, we cheated. I think we cheated. There might have nobody been around there. General, where are his captors? Oh. You came. I did. I'm sorry, I'm looking away from you. He's bound by some kind of manner of Magitek device. If I dare not force it open, he'd be well be booby trapped. Heard of such devices, the Crystal Braves use possess the key. Let us snap it up and have a look for it. That will not be necessary. Is it this fucking asshole? Oh, it's a Lalafell. Not who I was expecting. Oh dear, what has he got? Okay, he's closed it. Oh, iron cell. And the area is filling with gas, I'm assuming. That's what it looks like. Did he really do all this just to get at me? That's very childish. That dumb as well. Oh crap, freaking slime as well. Gross. Get out of here, slime. You're gross. I don't like you. Ugh. What are you doing? Oh, you were also killing one. You're just healing him, I guess. Okay, we did it. Are you just healing Robidon? The way is clear. Okay, come on, elf. We've got time for this shit. I shall tend to the general. The Braves have the key. Done that? No, probably not. Come on, elf. We ain't got time for this nonsense. Time for all your dilly dallying. Oh, crap. Where the hell are we going, elf? Ah, here we go. This seems the right way. There's mobs. So that's probably correct. I kind of like the idea of, like, whilst we're dealing with this shit, like, the dragon lady is just back there, just constantly pouring potions over him. Like, she's just like waterboarding him with fucking potions to keep him alive. Okay, J. jam. He's done with the jam. He's dead. Fuck him. Come on, Elf. We've got time for this nonsense. Well, in theory, you heal me, so you must be a freaking scholar, Elf. His vitality. Oh, crap. He's fucking dying. Am I even going the right fucking way? That's closed. Ah, up here. Up here, Elf. I see it. Right, let's get rid of this first. Oh, it's that, they're actually gonna kill me, Elf, if we don't get rid of them. He's got 33 vitality left. Let's get rid of the jam, and then we'll get rid of that thing. Okay. Man, I cannot have a long lifespan after this. I cannot die. Not yet. It's fine, dude, don't worry. Huh. Is that it? It took care of the mist. Does it, Elf? The mist is cleared. Fantastic. I'm assuming that they're talking through Link Shell, by the way. Not. To try and make some sense of it. Right, Conjurer. Let's get rid of the Conjurer first. Right, let's try and get the attention of all three of them. Because the elf, well... Why do they use AoEs? I never know. Right, I've used blood for blood, elf. I'm hoping that you can keep me alive. Ow! Elf! Please! I need healing. I'll mantra myself as well. Hopefully that'll get us a few extra points. Okay, now after this I suspect that we're gonna have the boss. I suspect anyway. Because these don't really last too long. Not in my opinion, anyway. They don't last too long because they're generally quite like challenging, essentially. Or they're meant to be challenging. Open? No? Oh, identification key. You had it. Why would you have the key? Whatever. Come on, Elf. That's what I intend to do. We're probably gonna come across something else along the way, you know that, right? God knows what. Fuck, there are like 17 fucking griffins or something just in a room. But, oh, good. Surprising these ball things aren't working either. Yeah, we'll just get there and there'll be like another mist problem or something. His vitality is 81 now, so I suppose Dragon Lady's doing her job somewhat. Oh. Okay, we're back. I got the doodad. Here we go. Let me just play around with this a little bit. Dude, you have seen better days. You should have known that the cleverness of the Warrior of Light. Well done, hero. Still not the Warrior of Light anymore. Oh, fuck. Okay, so the guy who chopped his arm off, a Lancer, and that Lalafell who just tried to poison us. Okie doke. I didn't have to assume that the Lalafell is going to be like their little conjurer. Oh no, they actually have a conjurer. Right, let's dub this like here. Let's start ourselves with running around action. Start our kiting, as it were.
I have you now.
Oh, sorry, what are you doing? Casting some short of spell. Right, let's get rid of this archer. Let's also try and... Oh, okay, she's pulled the Lancer. So we'll leave you with the Lancer. If we keep running around, hopefully that guy will just keep following us and we won't have to deal with it. Okay, we good? Oh, I'm using the wrong, holding on the wrong thing. Okay, not bad. Oops, there we go. Keep in mind, this is like, this is why my excuse of like, you know, when people say, who would win out of a fight of like, you know, certain jobs? It's like, bard because of bard OP bullshit. This is what I mean by that. Besides that? Nice move. Damn, that very much quite hurts us, doesn't it? Let's use a mantra. Just because we can. Aha! You thought I was going to let you... Oh, he actually hit me. Thought I was being a sneaky bugger. That'll lead you back in the fire. I want to try and keep you in the fire, but I have to stay quite close to you and you can hit me. And I don't like it when you can hit me. Bard OP bullshit doesn't work if fucking bullshit ass you can just punch me in the face. Yay.
It is over, Ilbert. Lay down your arms and surrender yourself to justice.
Justice? Justice for what exactly? 'Twas not I who assassinated the Sultana, boy.
Ere we debate who is responsible for the assassination, I would ask whether an assassination took place at all.
Oh, clever little shite.
If you think you fight for justice, lad, you'd best wake up. The truth is, you fight for whoever bloody well tells you to. Can you not? And how do I know this? Because I'm the same. A pawn to be used as my masters see fit. All I ever wanted was to liberate my homeland. And I ate dirt to make it happen. But what have I achieved after all these years in servitude? Nothing. Not a bloody thing. If we ourselves are not free, free to think and to act, how are we ever to reclaim our homeland? Know this. There is is nothing I would not give to take back Alamigo. Nothing!
You are very angry. Oh, he threw a flashbulb, but let me guess, he escaped.
You'll not get away!
Leave him. Yeah, there we go.
No, Master Alphano. Now is not the time.
We'll kill him at some point, I guess. We'll have to do another fight. Hey, dude.
I'm but a cripple and a fool. And still you came for me. I'm in your debt.
You still got one good arm. I mean, you chopped a fucking guy in half, remember?
We are all of us fools of fate, General.
Pretty impressive.
But even fools have a part to play.
We stand with you. On your feet, gladiator. Fight is not over. I like how happy my guy looks like he's saying that.
I was not planning to die till it avenged the Sultana. Still, your words are welcome, lad.
With a sword, or?
Know this, Ilbert. There is nothing I would not give to see you pay for what you've done. My wealth, my arm, my life. Nothing.
You already lost your wealth and your arm. So.
Are you aware that Lord Lolorito has yet to announce the Sultana's death to the public?
What? No. No, I was not aware of that, nor of anything else outside my cell. Tis passing strange, though. I assume the bastard would make it known at the first opportunity and set about tearing down the Sultanate.
As did we all. And it is indeed strange that he did not. Strange. Or perhaps revealing.
What? But how can that be?
Forgive me, friends, but it is not safe here. Let us continue this conversation without.
His arm is just gone. He looks very strange. About that. Wow, that was that was long. General safe. News are out. The guards have been subdued, as per your command. Sorry, no further activity. The minions must have fled via some other exit. Yeah, I guess so. General Adelan, I presume. My mistress is a friend. I come bearing a message of goodwill. The safety. She bade me direct the steps to the Waking Sand. Okay. I guess we have no choice. As you don't give me one, so let's go, I guess. Right, I'm not going to talk to him because I think that's going to start us a fucking huge ass cutscene. I'm going to leave it there for today and we will see this tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you still enjoyed the series as a whole. Remember to like, favorite, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.